Good morning, brothers. Just murdered a workout. Wet, sweating. It's gonna be a great day. Happy holidays to everyone. Today's the second video in my series of 14 things that I've learned in 14 years of being in a relationship as a rebooted man, as a man who had a problem out of control, a problem with pornography and masturbation and some other sexual behaviors, but not as much as porn and masturbation. The second thing is, don't be a bitch because of your finances. Here's what I mean. For 14 years, my girl and my finances have been separate. I don't think she even knows how much I make. She makes her own money, I make my own money. What's hers is hers, and what's mine is mine. When we started living together a few years ago, we then put together like a little expense account for, you know, household stuff and for, you know, dates and stuff like that. Now, I pay for the expense account. I'm just that kind of guy, right? I'll talk about that in another video, maybe this one, right? But it's something that's the only thing that we have financially that's shared. And this is super important because it is astounding. It has astounded me for years. The number of men who need their wife, or worse, you need your girlfriend's permission to spend money on something. You know what makes me fucking sick? I feel sick to the stomach. I feel like nauseous when a dude tells me that, oh, if I'm a good boy this year, you know, I can get that Xbox. I can buy that car. I can do that. Listen, one evening, a truck pulls up from, where the fuck, St. Louis, Missouri, in our front yard. And my girl's like, there's a truck out there. She's like, I'm about to start my meditation. I was like, oh yeah, my Porsche's in the truck. She's like, oh yeah, you bought one? I was like, yeah, I did. I'm gonna go, do you wanna come see? She's like, nah, I'm gonna do my meditation. She goes and meditates. I come out with my camera. I'm like, hey, what's up, man? How you doing? Thanks for driving the car. This is my first time seeing my Porsche. Comes out, parks in the car. I don't even drive it for like 2 weeks, right? I just take my vision board, take a picture. She doesn't ask me. She doesn't even look in the garage for days and days and days. Now, obviously, cars are not her thing, but there was no question of how much was it. There was nothing. Nothing. Right? At that point, we've been together for like over 10 years. What was this? This was like, shit, was this last year or so? 13 years already. No question about it. None. Right? That's the way I set up my relationship on purpose. I understand that that's not, some of you are sitting here going like, well, that's not possible for us. But I challenge you to question what doesn't make it possible. The reason why this is important is because for men in a relationship, freedom is so important. If you feel claustrophobic, if you feel that you are not free, and some area of your life is just tightened, you just can't do the shit you want to do, you're gonna turn to porn. And there are a lot of men who do that. They don't understand. They're like, oh, I just want to stop it. I'm like, well, you've got to be more free. You've got to be more free, right? Can you set things up with your family where you have delivered, like over-delivered to your family, if there's even anything like that, because you're supposed to be doing that every day, over-delivering to your family, to the point that you're just like, you know what, honey, like, I'm gonna fuck off for a week. Where you go? I don't know. I'm just gonna go sit on the beach somewhere. There's some books I wanna read. There's a men's group I wanna go to. There's a mastermind I wanna be a part of. Right? Right. Let's do that. And then next week or 2 weeks from now, a month from now, you can go do your own thing. I'll take care of the kids. I'll do whatever I can. You guys do that? Or is it just like, oh no, that's not possible. If I told that to my wife, she would flip out. Then what kind of fucking man are you? Seriously. When I was selling Bibles door to door, 11 years, I was young, I was 21 years old, right? But already I started feeling that nauseous feeling. I was like, why do I want to throw up in this motherfucker's face? When he looks at this book, we used to sell like educational books. There were some guys whose kids had learning disabilities, right? I've had a learning disability with math for a while. And I was using this book myself. It's for kids in elementary school. And I was like, damn, this book is good. So I started showing that to the parents. This guy's like, dude, my kid has like serious issues with math, serious issues with this and this. How come we can't find these online? Or we can't find these in the books? So I was like, well, that's why we do it door to door. These are specially published. And the only way you can get them is from college students who come through, because I was in an internship back then. It was attached to the business I eventually became the director of. Right? So it was just like, we got college credit for doing these, and these are, you know, they're updated every couple of years. And he was like, man, my kids really need this. Right? How much is it? I would tell him and be like, well, you know what? Gotta talk to the boss. At 21 years old, I was already sick hearing that shit. Not because it was an objection and I wouldn't get the sale or anything like that. Because I didn't understand how his wife had anything to do with the decision he had to make about something from their own kids. Didn't your dick have something to do with this kid being born? Like, I'm moving on. I'm a traveling salesman. But you want to talk to your wife about this? And you know the worst part of it? I think the thing that really makes me nauseous is, that's some cowardly shit. I really mean it. It's from men who are scared. They are afraid of the drama, the emotional validation bullshit that's going to come up when their partner is just like, well, why did you get that without talking to me? Right? Why didn't you seek my permission for that? What the fuck do you go to work for? Like, what do you work for? Like, what? These guys who work and they come back and they're just like, honey, here's all my money. You're an idiot. Unless you're an addict. Unless you have a spending problem. And at some point, you've got to fix that shit, right? And take control of your own finances. This is a big thing, because a lot of relationships end because of finances. A lot of relationships end because of finances. People arguing about finances. Go out there and work your ass off. That's what you're supposed to do. I really mean it. Go out there and work your ass off. Get fit, have the energy, wake up earlier, spend time with your kids. And for those of you who don't have kids, you have no fucking excuse. If a dude shows up to speak to one of my reboot strategists, and then he says something like, you know, I gotta talk to my girlfriend before I make this decision. I mean, I don't tell my strategist to use rude words, but if I'm on the call, I'd be like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Well, you know, I've been dating this girl, but like in 1 week, they are already exhibiting the bitch material that they were made from because your daddy did that. You watched your dad tell the door-to-door guy that, yeah, daddy, I really want that book. Daddy, that's good for daddy. That's what I'll need. Well, honey, we, you know, we need to talk to mommy about this, right? Young man, can you come back on another day? He saw you exhibit that bitch behavior. He saw you say things like, my wife wears the pants and all this bullshit. And now he's doing it with his girlfriend that he's been living with for 3 months. Met her 3 months ago, already living with her. Stupidity. So guys, that's my second lesson for you. Keep your finances separate. Be financially independent. If you feel that you need like a joint income in the home because it makes you feel secure, you have a problem. Don't worry about that. If your partner is financially secure, if your partner loves you and supports you, and you guys have been together, you all have history together, if the relationship is in trouble and the relationship is worth a damn, she will show up to support you. Despite all of this, my girl doesn't sit around just spending my money, right? She'll often ask. She's like, you know what, I can take care of this. And once in a while, just for the fucks of it, I'm just like, yeah, sure, like whatever, if you insist. But it has no impact on my net worth or anything. And when she got together with me, I was broke. No furniture, nothing. Well, you guys know the furniture story. I only got furniture like 2 years ago. I just didn't need furniture, right? So brothers, in 14 years of my relationship as a rebooted man, we have never, ever, ever had an argument about money. Never, ever. It's not even happened one time. That's a fact. So it's possible. You just need to set your relationship up the right way. And then one final thing. Early on in our relationship, we used to go Dutch. I still hadn't taken full responsibility for my finances. The moment I took full responsibility for my finances, that was it. She didn't pay for shit anymore. As long as she was feminine and she was doing the things that fulfilled me in the relationship, I made sure I was doing the things that fulfilled her. And you gotta know your own partner, know her love language, whatever the fuck it is, right? You need to understand them. For some women, they need security. And I'm not talking about a love language here. Like, if she feels secure, right? She feels that she's like, this man has got my back. In terms of physical safety, in terms of financial safety. And I'm the type of person that, like, if I'm taking care of your family too, right? Not the freeloaders, not the fucking losers. Like, if they show up, I'll give them a pep talk, right? When a family member shows up and is talking shit around me, I'm like, dude, no. Like, get your shit together before you come in here again and start running your mouth. I don't want to talk to you, right? But aging mom, aging dad, like a family. Like, that's family. You've been with me together for that long, I've got you. I'm going Dutch on shit once you've taken responsibility for your finances. Whatever fucking excuse is going through your head right now, you need to sit down, brothers, and you need to examine it. And then you need to fix that shit. Now, with all that being said, that's what worked for me. So, take what works from there for yourself, and you can forget the rest. I'm JK, your brother in the struggle. Thank you so much for taking the time to watch this video. I'll speak to you tomorrow with another vulgar, curse-filled video on 14 things that I learned in 14 years of my relationship as a rebooted man. Talk to you guys later. Bye.